Hey.
So before we actually begin talking about bids, we have an announcement from the Dublin 2019 Worldcon. You may recall that they've already happened, so they're not a bid anymore. But Tammy Caxton is here to make a couple of presentations. Tammy?
Could I have the chairs?
Can I have the chairs or representatives of DISCON 3 at Con Zealand please come forward? On behalf of Dublin 2019, I'd like to say, you get a check! And you get a check! Good luck with your convention. Thank you very much.
Can I get JC to co-sign this check?
Dublin just gave $10,000 in pass along funds to each of DISCON 3 and Con Zealand. The pass along program, for those of you who are new to this whole enterprise, is a way that Worldcons who have had successful years can help future Worldcons, and we pass it along. It's not a formal contract, it is an agreement we make for all of them. So, thank you very much. So we're going to actually talk about bids for 2020, and for the SMOFCon 38. And we have on the list two people. So do you want to pop up the first slide? So can I have the folks from Cleveland? Eric and Laura? I'm from Cleveland. It's a great place to be from.
Oh, sorry.
Please feel free to stand or whatever. That happened a lot, actually, but it was only one that anybody remembered, and I think these folks are too young to remember it, but I do.
Is the mayor still on fire?
Depends on what day of the week. I'm Eric. This is Laura. This is Amy. We are from Cleveland. This is going to be a very short presentation because we did run into some 23rd hour contract issues with the hotel we were looking at hosting that we were not able to overcome, and so we do have to officially withdraw our bid for 2020. We've already done some pre-work, and we are planning on reinitiating a bid as soon as we get things together in completion that we can let people know the information. We are currently looking at 2022, and as soon as we get information, we will certainly disperse it to everybody so that everybody's on the same page.
Thank you very much. So we have a bid for 2020 from Montreal. Where's Montreal? Okay, besides Canada.
Way north.
Yes, but drag your sorry ass up here, would you? Because this is where the microphones are.
Do not forget to get your clicker on the way.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, you can see.
Oh, anywhere in this room, that will work. If you want to jog around it and use the remote, you can.
But don't hold the microphone in front of the speaker. Right. Yeah.
Yes.
Hello, hopefully you guys know me by now. It's been several years.
Hi, Jenny.
Thank you. So, as a preface as usual, we'd like our past and current CANSMOF scholarship work recipients to stand up, please. There's one. There's Lisa. So yes, and we will be wrapping up as usual. Thank you. So, so this is Kevin. You guys all know
Kevin, right?
I'm the other Kevin.
Yes, I'm the other. I'm Paul Kevin, and I'm on the CANSMOF board of directors. So we are the directors here, yes.
Yes, we are the directors here, and CANSMOF will be sponsoring our bid for SMOFCon. And so a little bit to tell you, okay? Let's see if I can work with that. And there's not a lot of text. I like pretty pictures. There we go. So surface SMOFs. What does it take to put together something like a circ? And I'm not talking about the not my circus, not my monkey thing. I'm talking about what it takes to put on a good show. Teamwork. Balancing the budget, because if you got no money, you can't do it. Exotic attractions. Very important. Chasing unicorns, which are your dreams. Keeping it together, you know, no falling apart. And to come up with more than a dog and pony show. So this is the view from our hotel in Montreal. It's a little bit of a change because I know in previous years we've said the Holiday Inn, which is the one with the pagodas in Chinatown. Well, we got a really good offer from Le Centre Sheraton. And they made us an offer that we're going, oh yeah, and the view that comes with it. This is our this is about half of the ballroom that we're proposing to use for things like the Fannish Inquisition and the larger events. This is about two-thirds of our hospitality suites. And our hospitality suites, because it's on a special floor, can bring in anything from the outside. Yay. All the other floors require catering. We can bring anything we want into here.
Ooh. Thank you.
And it's a newly renovated hotel. In fact, their renovations will be finished this spring, but it's all new decor.
30 seconds.
Okay, here's our rates. We're cheap. The exchange is good. We got in Montreal. We've got stuff to eat, things to see during the holiday season, holiday markets. And for those of you who are really interested, it's not just about Christmas.
Dates.
Dates. It is December 4th to the 7th, the class weekend. Yes.
That's
pretty much it.
So, what's the thing that's got you most excited about bringing this back to Montreal?
Everything, because since 2009, when we had anticipation, thanks to the fact of, okay, we had the sequicentennial, you guys didn't come, that's okay, we had a great time anyway. Sequicentennial, we have a new technology school, there's a lot of evolution in the city, there's many things that have been changed since. But the food is still good. I mean, to give you an example of some of the things that have changed, for example, the best cocktail bar in Montreal is in Chinatown. It's a tiki cocktail bar, and it's under a tacabean.
That's wonderful.
Which is, you know, that gives you an idea of how Montreal is mixing things up.
So right now, what's causing you the most stress for your bid?
Well, I was stressed out about Cleveland, and I heard rumors, but I wouldn't believe it until they actually came up and said it, because, you know, I'm nervous that way.
So from a location point of view, for those of us who are in anticipation, where is this in relation to that?
Okay, so those of you who remember where the Delta is and the Bonaventure, which were our two major hotels, the Le Centre Sheraton is right, it's like diagonally across the street from the Bonaventure, which has also been renovated, FYI.
So it's right in the whole town area?
Yeah, it's in the downtown core. It's, you know, you can take the 747 bus in, take it to taxi, it's not going to cost you more than $40 Canadian because it's capped, or, you know, any other ways of coming in, but once you are in the center, you are in the center. You don't have any needs to have a car, you know, you can get the metro, it's like one or two metro stations up from the Palais de Congrès.
And it's not too far from the train station, either.
No, it's just down the street from the train station.
So you can take the train even from the States.
You can take the train from the States.
I've done it. It's fine.
Except the time I tried to do it, but it's, you know, early morning, but you came from the other room.
Next question,
sorry.
Given the increased amount of space that's often necessary and the capacity of your proposed venues, do you think that if you actually get more people than, you know, this average of SMOFCon, because suddenly everybody goes, oh, I want to go to Montreal, how many people do you think you can fit in service?
The Centre Sheraton is a international business class hotel. It has 37 floors, 36 of which, no, I take that back, I would say safely, you know, 35 of which are guest room floors.
Yeah, but How much space have you reserved, I guess is the question.
Oh, how much space have we reserved? We use the usual room pickup, the historic room pickup, so we are at 250 over the period of our convention, but we can change that.
So we're not actually competing at the moment with space. You're not sort of...
No, I mean, we basically have... No. We effectively have all of the... I'm sorry, I don't have the map up here. But we have basically, except for one or two rooms on level A, we have both level A and level B, which is below the surface. It's underground.
Okay. Function space.
Yes, function space. We have all that function space.
So, how many rooms in terms of functions?
In terms of rooms, okay, so the major function space like this is an ABC ballroom with we can put a couple of barrels if we have to. And then,
bigger than this room.
Yeah, it's bigger than this room. And then the other ones are, I believe, five or six function rooms on level eight.
We haven't received any additional questions. If you have questions, you can ask for a runner.
Oh,
and
before I forget.
Bring you a pad of paper and a pen. Oops.
Did I see a hand?
So we have a question here and a question over there.
And while we're doing the questions, Sean, Lee, and Bastion will help hand out the freebies that I brought. Yes.
Oh, excuse me. The single
most important thing that we need to announce, which we didn't up front, is that all swag goes to the head table first.
Yes.
So cookies, freebies.
Maple, of course.
That's
maple candy
definitely comes up here first.
Maple candy is circulating.
So
who's got the maple candy?
Yeah, brings them up here so these guys get it. We're in trouble.
Yes, so they're going to fire us already.
It's over there.
We'll Cirque du Soleil be in town.
I'm not sure yet, but they're not unknown to have winter shows. And for those of you who like hockey, the apps will be.
Okay.
Hockey.
Ah.
Thank you. I think this word is parking. How much is parking?
Our hotel does have parking, and it is $25.
Okay. It might be parakeets. So
$25 in and out. $25
in and out. $25 in and out is hotel parking. Daily. Yeah.
Oh. Okay. So any other? No. We get to make decisions about which wise ask questions we'll actually ask. So
thank you for that.
If there are no other questions for the bid, we have a decision making process that's really hard and that sort of thing. We would like to make a decision about where we will meet next year, around this time. And so we have the bidder, and that's Montreal. Could I have the usual motion?
Accept by acclamation.
So there has been a motion that we accept by acclamation. Is anybody good with that? Is everybody good with that?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you very much, Montreal. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Next
important question. Memberships.
Yeah.
Memberships. Will you be accepting?
We'll have them at the fan table tomorrow.
I didn't
mean... table session.
I didn't even get a chance to tell Lisa she didn't need to record that. It was so fast.
All right. Yes. Okay.